Hello everyone, welcome to Science and Environment series with Dr. Wayne Rana. Topic for today's discussion is sandalwood spike disease, SSD. This is a plant disease which is threatening the entire population of red sanders, a tree which has a lot of economic significance for South India. So we'll be decoding what this disease is and what is the economic significance of red sanders. Whenever examiner is going to frame a question, it's not going to be limited only on disease, or you could say only on the ecological significance. You have to prepare the both themes comprehensively if the question at all arises from this section. So let's decode the sandalwood spike disease, because you have seen in 2019-2020 phase, it's the human viral diseases which have been dominating headlines, and plant diseases, whenever they are, they tend to get ignored unless they are impacting our food grains like rust of wheat, smut of wheat, dicker disease of groundnut. These are some of the popular diseases. So at times we tend to ignore the plant diseases, but this should not be the case, because both flora and fauna have equal importance in our ecosystem. So first of all, let's decode the causative agent, because the causative agent is itself something you have not likely to be heard before. It is caused by the phytoplasma. Now this term phyto is more or less likely to plant, and this plasma word they have derived because this organism is a small size bacteria which is almost mycoplasma like organism. Mycoplasma is one of the smallest bacteria we know. It's pleuromorphic pneumonia like organism. So in simple words, you could say it's a bacterial disease, because in plants what we see is generally the diseases are the fungal ones, or they are vector viral as well. So this is one of the bacterial diseases which is quite a damaging one. And initially this organism was considered to be a form of virus, but later studies, when they studied its structure in electron microscopy, they deduced that it is a close organism related to bacteria. So it's a small species, that's why detecting it is always a challenge. Then coming to the vector, this is a vector-borne disease, because once a sandalwood gets infected, the next one also gets infected, and it's mainly the transmission is through insects. So the insect is not a tough one to memorize, it's a leaf hopper. So one leaf hopper is carrying this bacteria, might transmit it to another plant, and in close vicinity, generally the forest, since the plant in close vicinity, they get infected. So if they ask you what is the vector, you have to pick the leaf hopper. So what exactly are the characteristics of this disease? The first and foremost is this disease is characterized by reduction in leaf size. This is a normal red sanders and this is the infected one. So you can see there is a drastic reduction in size of leaves, which directly will lead to lesser photosynthesis and lower productivity. And also you can see the internodal length is reduced drastically, and that gives it an appearance of a spike in fluorescence. In extreme cases, even the stem appears like a rosette spike. So this is what the name comes from. So this is botany students can relate more to the inflorescence part of the spike inflorescence. So commonly you just have to memorize that the leaf as well as the internodal length get reduced. In the later stage, the leaf turns yellow or red, eventually the tree dies. So you have to understand that this disease has no treatment or cure available. So only remedy is to cut the infected tree so that it does not transmit to another one. So this is where the economic damage of this disease is widespread. And it is not something that it's a new disease which is just come into picture, just like in human we have seen the corona impacting our lives. This disease was the first time confirmed in India in 1899 in the Coorg district of Karnataka. You could say Kodagu was the exact location where it has. So it had transmitted to even Mysore as well. So these are the regions where the disease currently is once again outbreaking in the Kerala as well as Karnataka regions. And especially you could say the MM Hills is the specific site where the maximum cases have been detected so far. So So these are the, some of the characteristics of the disease. So make sure you don't confuse it with some North Indian or Northeastern disease. This disease is limited to Southern India historically as well, or as well the current episode. Now coming to the economic significance of red centers, the sandalwood tree is a tree which is endemic to South India. You will mainly find it in the Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. This tree is used mainly for east sandalwood, for derived east sandalwood, as well as the sandalwood oil, which has a commercial value. So this tree is mainly used for cosmetic and medicinal industry, and also it is also used for musical instruments as well and woodwork as well. That these are some of the associated benefits. So this is quite a useful tree for our country as well. So IUCN status of this tree at time was endangered. This tree was not allowed to be exported, and you must have heard about the illegal felling as well as the, you could say, exporting of this red sandalwood. There were a lot of the persons involved, but now this has been controlled. But now the current status is in the near threatened category, which is comparatively less riskier category if you have gone through IUCN red list. And also in the CITES convention, which is the convention on international trade of endangered species, it is listed in appendix 2. So globally also this tree is recognized as of significant, because appendix 2 is also important. Had it been appendix 1, even the provisions would have been more stringent and more protection would have been given. So this is what you have to cover in the red sandalwood. So because it's the examiner description, a geographic examiner might ask about the distribution, what kind of forest regions in which it is, this tree is distributed. A biology examiner will be more or less interested in the causative agent, what exactly is the phytoplasma, is it a bacterial viral disease. And environmentalists would be more interested in the nature of disease, whether it is transmitted by some insect or it is an inborn disease, and what is the ecological significance, why we should protect this near threatened species. So make sure that this is, since the theme is an overlapping one with the biology, science and geography, such themes at times are more likely to be asked in examination. So all the aspirants who have been preparing for IAS 2021 or 22, this theme, if it stays in news for next 1 month, then this could be one of the themes which can be picked for examination. So if you have any specific queries, you could ask them in comment section. I will try to answer the best I could. So this is what we have in today's disease series, sandalwood spike disease, SSD. So thank you very much. Have a nice day.